Good morning, everyone. I hope you're having a great day. For my devotion today, I want to share from the letter of Romans, chapter 2, verse 1 to 4. And if you can, I want to encourage you to read these verses with me. You therefore have no excuse, you who pass judgment on someone else, for at whatever point you judge the other, you are condemning yourself. Because you who pass judgment do the same things. Now we know that God's judgment against those who do such things is based on truth. So when you, a mere man, pass judgment on them and yet do the same things, do you think you will escape God's judgment? Or do you show contempt for the riches of His kindness, tolerance, and patience? Not realizing that God's kindness leads you toward repentance? Amen. In this chapter, the Apostle Paul turns to address those who think themselves to be morally superior. While he is ultimately targeting pious Jews, this warning actually applies to any of us who have the tendency to condemn those we believe to be worse sinners than us. But when God looks at us, it could be very different from our viewpoint, because His law does not only condemn obvious sins done in public, it also accuses our secret attitudes, thoughts, and desires. The reason the judgment of God does not come immediately is not because of our goodness, but God's patience. Through this passage, we can be reminded once again that self-righteousness is very dangerous because it blinds us from our own sin and prevents us from pursuing repentance. If we have some time today, let us try to read this passage one more time and have a time of reflection to see if there is any sin that we still need to confess. And let us have a time of repentance. I hope and pray we will continue to pursue the humility of Jesus Christ in our everyday life. Our faith is all about heart, will, and action. So as we start our day today, let us ask ourselves these two questions. First, these days, what fruit in our lives confirms that we have been transformed by the gospel? Secondly, how can we encourage others around us to pursue a more active faith in our lives? Let's pray. Dear Lord, we thank you for saving us through your Son, Jesus. Thank you for your forgiveness and grace and kindness to us. Lord, I pray that you will help us to grow to be more like your Son, Jesus, and help us to pursue humility and kindness and forgiveness. And Lord, please break down our pride and unite us as one body to truly treat each other in a way that you have treated us. Lord, in all the spiritual warfares today, pray that you will be with us and help us to move forward victoriously in faith. Lord, we thank you in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.